Django comes with an awesome feature called database migrations. Database migrations can be used to automatically create and make changes to our database based on what we change in the models. It works by taking a look at the current state of the database and the current state of our models and seeing what the differences are. So Django does this all for us in the background, and it saves us a lot of time because it means that Django manages all the changes to our database on our behalf. So we don't need to make any tedious SQL queries or commands or anything to make the changes that we need when we update our database with new models or new fields. So let's create our first Django database migration. You create the Django database migrations using the management command that comes with Django. So let's minimize Atom and load up the git bash or the terminal window and run our Vagrant server. So type Vagrant up and if Vagrant's already running, it should be quite quick. And then type Vagrant SSH to connect to it. Okay, so now that we're logged onto the server, let's switch to our profiles API virtual environment. So type work on profiles API. And now we're gonna change to the project location on the server. So cd /vagrant/src/profiles project. And from the profiles project location, we're gonna run the manage.py command. So type Python manage.py, and the command we're gonna use is the make migrations command. What this is gonna do is it's gonna check our models, it's gonna check the database, and it's gonna make a migration file that contains all of the changes from what's existing in the database to what we've changed in the models. Because this is the first time we're running the migrations, currently there is no database, so Django will automatically just create the migration that will set up our database for the first time. So type Python manage make migrations and hit enter. So what's happened here? Well, it appears that we have an error in our models file, and Django is kindly telling us about this error now. So it's saying in this file, in the models file that we were working with earlier on line 39, there's a problem with the doc string. So let's go and fix that before we continue. Load up Atom Editor and go back to our models.py file, and let's locate line 39 in the system. So that's this line here. So the error is that we've accidentally added an extra quotation mark here. So delete the quotation mark because there needs to be only 3 at the beginning and 3 at the end. And then save the file. And let's head back to the git bash. And you can use the up key to load the last command that we called, so you don't have to type it again. Python manage.py make migrations and hit enter. Let's see if it works this time. There you go. So this time it worked, and we have it says here create model user profile. So let's just load up our Atom editor and look at what's changed here. You can see that within our profiles API, it's made a change to this migrations directory, and it's added a new file called 0001 initial. So we don't really need to worry too much about what this does here, but let's look at it anyway, just so that we can get an understanding. So this is created by Django automatically. And what this migration file does is it tells Django how to set up our database. And because this was our first migration, it created the initial file. So this is the initial database setup when you first run the app. So we don't need to change this. Let's close this off. And now let's run our migration to create our database. So head back to the git bash, and we're gonna use the same manage.py command, but this time we're gonna call a migrate command. So Python manage.py migrate. What this is gonna do is gonna go through all of our database migrations, and it's gonna run them on our database. So hit enter. You can see that it's gone ahead and it's created a bunch of things here, and they've all said okay, which is good. So it's run our migration. Where is our one? So our one is here, and these ones around it are migration files that are included with the different Django apps that we're using. So because we're using the Django auth app, it's created the auth table. Because we're using the Django sessions, it's created the sessions table, and it's created a table for the admin. So it's created migrations, or it's run the migrations for all the different apps that we're using in our project. And it's created a SQLite file here. So this db.sqlite. Now, I don't recommend clicking on this because it's a big binary file, and if you click on it, it can sometimes crash the Atom editor. Okay, so let's just run the migrations again so we can see what happens if we run it a second time. You can see that because it already ran these, it already applied them to the database, the second time we ran it, it says there's no migrations to apply. So Django can see that all of the migrations we have in our system have already been applied to our database and that it doesn't need to apply anymore. If we were to create more changes or more migrations, then it would run the differences from the last time we ran the Python manage migrate command. Okay, so that's how we run our migrations and create our migrations in the system. Now that we've done that, let's commit our changes to Git. So I'm gonna load up a new Git bash window here and type cd workspace profiles REST API. And we're gonna add all of the files by typing git add dot enter, and we're going to commit our changes. So we're going to type git commit hyphen a for all, m for message, and we're going to describe the changes that we made, which is added a custom user profile model, a manager, and the migrations for our database. Close that off and hit enter. Okay, so our changes have been committed to the database. That's how you create a custom user model, custom user manager, and migrations in the Django system. And that's how you apply the migration to the database. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.